And we are live. Hey guys, what's going on? Waiting for some people to join here. Already 12 people. Wow. What's up? 33. We're counting up here. Hey, what's going on? Hi. How's y'all's day? Living the dream, I hope. Hi there. Let's get this. Hey, what's going on? If you have any questions, feel free to throw them out there. I'm here to answer. What's going on, guys? Hi. We still got people, a bunch of people joining. This is awesome. In the middle, before some questions start piling in, I'll fill you guys in on how my day's going so far. I woke up, and that's about it. Let's see here. It's the father of the baby from Steffi. I can't give away any information. If you don't know that yet, I'm gonna leave that up to the intrawebs for you. Let's see here. How's it with the Christmas tree? With the Christmas, I don't have it up anymore. I had it up for a long time, and I just put it away about 5 minutes ago. I'm lovely. Aw, you're lovely. Thank you. How many times do I go to the gym, Pernilia? I hope I said that right. Hope I'm getting these names right. If I do, if I don't, you'd have to forgive me. How many times do I go to the gym? Right now I don't go to the gym at all. But I have I built a little gym in my garage, and it depends on how much I'm working, but 4 or 5 days a week, I'll get a good workout in. You want to shave off your beard, Lizette? This kind of just happened. We had a few months off, and I got lazy. And then when we came back, just with the headspace that Thomas was in, it felt like he was such a mess that that this worked. And then I just kept it. Do I want to shave it off? Some days. Some days I want to buzz my head. But, you know, it's not that big of a deal. Deborah asks, do you want to marry me? Maybe. It depends. You see, we don't know how we would align together. But I would say, given the distance between us, it's going to be a tough road. Patty, how did my audition for The Bold go? Okay, so that was an interesting ride. So actually, I went in a few years earlier and met Brad for the role of Thomas. But this was when I was still on Young and the Restless. I just had a great meeting with Brad, and I think that he liked me for the role of Thomas. We weren't able to make it work then, but I think it was Pearson Fode came in, and he did a great job from what I hear, and he's a really nice guy. We have some mutual friends, and I've hung out with him a few times. He's a good guy. But then the audition this time was like a weird scenario. They threw out the thing online saying, you know, we're looking for Thomas Forrester. My agent called me, and I was like, yeah, that's the role that if I'm going to be on Bold, or if I'm going to go back into daytime, I think that's my role. And I went in, and it just felt great in the room, met everybody, and they started writing for the character, and it was, it's been awesome ever since. I've loved it. Who's my bestie on set? Bestie's a tough question. Who's my best? I mean, Annika and I obviously are really close because we just have so many scenes together, and she's such an awesome person. We connect. We just understand each other. And so, you know, I love working with her. And then obviously Scott. Scott and I have become friends. I love attacking him whenever I can, both in real life and on set, and I think he just loves it too. So Are there any real relationships on set? I can't give away that information. My goodness. Unless it's already public. Obviously, there's like, you know, Darren and his wife. And but no, I'm not going to give away any real relationships, though. I had a real relationship with the mannequin. I don't think anybody really knows that, but in real life, we would have conversations. It wasn't romantic. It was just friends, but we had a good time. Will you play in movies too? Saskia. I hope I get all your names right. It's such a cool name, Saskia. Will I play in movies too? Yeah, I've done a few movies, and obviously right now the the time constraint with working on the show is tough. So sometimes when we get hiatus time, I'll be able to go off and shoot a film somewhere. But yeah, I mean, I love working, so I constantly want to just be on set. So whenever I can do that, that's great. Greetings from Spain. Do you always agree with the script? Do I always agree with the script? I don't think anybody always agrees with the script. I mean, I think that I, you know, I'm not a writer, so I can, but I can put in my two cents, and I think that they do enjoy, you know, because we're working on this like it's on the fly constantly, so it's like this. It's a hard job to try and get all of this material on tape and to try and do it as well as we possibly can. So, you know, the best idea if we end up on set and we say, you know, maybe this doesn't work, or could I say this instead of that, you know, just because it makes more sense for the character or whatever, we can all collaborate really quickly and try and come up with a solution. And that's kind of the fun. It's like the problem solving on the show is a lot of fun. Let's see here. Vera, what is your funniest moment in The Bold and the Beautiful? Well, my funniest moment? I guess that's up for you to decide. My funniest moment maybe on set. God, I've had so many. It's just, I mean, how do you yell cut and then you're still staring at a mannequin in front of you? I mean, that in itself is ridiculous. So I don't know. It's like, but every time I get to work with Scott, because him and I basically just joke around, and we never get any work done, and we hold up the show and the production, and it's a blast, but they get mad at us. Franzian, how is Steffi as a sister? Oh, Jackie. Terrible. She's a horrible human being. I can't stand working with her. If we could pass this along to the higher-ups, that would be great. Obviously, I love Jackie. She's incredible. She's one of the best, just the best presence to have around, and you know, I wonder when she's gonna pop. She's got a baby that she's had cooking for like 9.5 months now. So we're all excited for the new Steffi clan to come out. Let's see here. So me and my three friends love you. Oh, Sasan, Claudia, and Karen. Let's go through these. Me and my three friends love you. Well, I love you. Thank you so much for watching the show. Claudia, what would be your dream part? That's a really tough question. There's so many of them. But I think when I started acting, doing comedy was always my, I love doing that. And I've had a few shows that have booked and worked as pilots, but never actually went to air. And, but I would love to do like a sitcom, something like Friends or something like that. Karen, do you have a cat or dog? I'm sort of like a partial, I'm like the, everyone just gives me their dogs cause I love dogs. But I need my own dog. And if anybody has any suggestions, I think I want like a Husky or a German Shepherd, something like that. I am a dog guy. I like cats. We had cats growing up when I was young. Dandy and Cricket were their names, two of them. And then I had a beagle when I was young as well, and her name was Molly. Anyway, let's see here. Rowena. I hope I said that right. Rowena, what's it like to work on set with the corona measures? Well, Rowena, it's interesting. It's weird, but at the same time, you know, this is sort of one of those interesting things. It's like we're actually learning in a way. We're having to reassess how we do things to try and meet these standards, and also to try and, you know, keep everyone safe, that whole thing. But I think during that process, what's really cool is that we're able to come up with solutions that we weren't even thinking about for problems we didn't even, or we knew kind of existed, but we never rethought the process. And so, like, this is one I brought up. I don't know if we'll keep this, but in the mornings we used to do rehearsal at 9 a.m. every day, and that you would have to rehearse like a block of, you know, 20 scenes or whatever. And by the time you get to the end of the day of shooting, you've forgotten half the blocking. You wrote some of it down, but you really have to go through it again and that sort of thing. And now we don't do the blocking in the morning because it's just limited exposure. So we just do quick blocking right before we shoot the scenes. But I think since we shoot this show in such a fast paced way, it's actually kind of nice to do that because it keeps it fresh in your memory and you don't have to be there at 9 a.m. every day if you don't have to. So I guess in that way, you know, it's just, I'm trying to see the glass half full here. Other than that, it sucks. Let's see here. Janny, are you friends in real life with Liam, Scott, and I? Friends is that's a loosely defined term. He's a person that exists in my life. we just went. Actually, we've gone on two camping trips in the last couple of. Like last month almost, it feels like. I constantly go camping. I'm always out exploring and camping, and he loves camping, but I don't think he goes that much. And so he kind of reached out and was like, hey, you know, whenever you go camping, let's do it. And now we've gone a couple times. I think he's really enjoying it. I love spending time with Scott. Let's see here. Monique, can you speak Dutch? I don't. No, that was, I'm not even going to try. I thought about it for a minute. I spoke a little German in high school because I had a friend that was from Germany and didn't speak any English when she got to the States. I took French class for like 5 years, and all I walked away with was un, deux, trois, and that's about it. Je m'appelle Mathieu. Anyway, let's see here. Did Steffi prank you yet? Legia. I hope I said one of those was correct. I hope. And I'm sure either one of those sound like a beautiful name. Has she pranked me yet? Well, I mean, it depends on what you mean by prank. We give each other crap all the time. no, but she hasn't like pulled an official prank other than the other week when she did that TikTok thing, and she called me, and that's on her page, and then she didn't call me back, and that actually hurt my feelings. So, Marianne, I watched the show for 30 years now. Thank you so much, Marianne. Thank you for watching the show. It's people like you that are the reason I have a job, you know, and I hope that we keep you entertained. Let's see here, Binium. I'm sorry if I'm ruining all these names. Binem. I'm sure it's an amazing name and I'm butchering it right now. What do you like to do in real life? I love going camping. I mean, that's just like adventuring, exploring, being out in God's green earth, just exploring and seeing what there is. So I love hiking. I love camping. Obviously there's working out and I love cars and trucks and stuff. So like, if I could build up a truck to go out to the desert or a car to drive fast around a track, that I love doing as well. Let's see here. Sherilyn, how long does it take for you to become like the Hulk? I don't think I'm anywhere like the Hulk. I would say Lawrence is more, you know, Carter on the show is more hulky than I am. That guy is like a statue carved out of marble or something. But to get where I'm at now, I don't know. I for years and years, I've just loved staying fit and staying healthy. And sometimes I just get into lifting heavier weights. And when I do that, I somehow balloon up a little bit in size. And sometimes I'm not so big. But I would say my whole life. That's the answer. Karen, are you at home now? Can you give us a tour? I won't give you a tour because the whole place is a mess, but I am at home. This is my a place I just got a couple of months ago, and I'm if you've seen on my Instagram, I've been doing a lot of home renovations in the last couple of months because it was sort of not in bad shape. It was just like, you know, outdated. So yeah, there you go. Z, how did you cut your thumb? How did you even see that? My goodness, it's actually not a cut. I've actually got two right now. So I was a bartender for years, and whenever I like have my hands in cold water so much, I'm constantly washing dishes or whatever, which I've been washing a lot of things lately. I just end up with like cracked spots, like just it's just like a dry skin, you know, sort of thing. So I just figured if I wrap it in something and put some Neosporin on there, then it heals up quicker. Let's see here. Tony, would you like to come to the Netherlands and have coffee? I would love to have coffee with you, Tony. That would be amazing.
I found this on the web.
And for some reason, Siri is responding to me. Tony, yes, I should come to the Netherlands and we should have coffee. I don't know where in the Netherlands you are. And I don't know what coffee shops are around, so you're gonna have to take reins on that one. So send me a message. Let me know where I should meet you and when. And then obviously we gotta work it out with the Bold and the Beautiful because I got a schedule. Okay, Prissy, I like you better in real life. Thank you. I guess. Yeah. No. Well, you know, Thomas is a little obsessive and slightly intense, I would say. And I am not quite as, well, I'm probably pretty intense at times, but I'm not quite as obsessive or crazy in real life. I don't run people off the road. I don't jump into vats of acid. That wasn't my fault. Anyway, so let's say, what would you do if you weren't an actor? Kimberly says, if I wasn't an actor, what would I do? Maybe a race car driver. Actually the reality is that I was going to join the Marines, and then my plan was to do SEAL training and become a SEAL. When I was a kid, I wanted to be a fighter pilot for a long time, and but then I realized I was too tall and I wasn't born with 20/20 vision, so there's a whole lot of things working against me. But I thought it would be really cool to become a SEAL in the military, and I know a lot of guys that did that sort of thing, and it's an honorable thing to do. And I didn't do that. I wussed out and started playing make-believe for a living. So, but, you know, it's worked out okay so far, so I guess I shouldn't have regrets. let's see here. Can I say something in Dutch? Sandra, I don't know. I'm going to try. Ik hou van jullie. Ik hou van jullie. Was that Dutch or I don't even know what I just said. That clip right there is going to be taken. And then, you know, like 5 years from now, I'm going to be on the Tonight Show and they'd be like, you said this horrible thing you need to own to your actions. And they're just going to have that clip and not have any of this. And then, I'm not going to work again a day in my life. Anyway. Okay. So, Carmen, we miss your son Douglas on the show. I know he gets to come back. Not uber regularly. I mean, it's just, it has to do with the COVID thing, you know, and obviously kids don't really get affected at all by the virus, as far as I know, and but they can transmit it. But I think that there's just like a general safety aspect. If we don't have to bring someone in, we don't bring them in, which sucks because I love all these people. Henry is the sweetest kid ever. And I hope that soon we drop those measures, but you know, you got to do what you got to do. But I love him too, and he does come back though. He's going to be in some scenes. I just shot some scenes with him, so something to look forward to. Okay, Edna, Edna, do you have children in real life? Do I have children in real life? No. No, I don't. I don't. I'm looking forward to having some children in real life, but none yet. Celine, what's the nicest place you've ever been? What's the nicest place you've ever been? Where's the nicest place I've ever been? The nicest. That's a tough. Depends on what you mean by nice. We got to define that term first. But the nicest place. That's tough. I mean, obviously, tropical places come to mind because, you know, it's nice laying on a beach in the warm sun. But, you know, I love places like Yosemite. And I go camping there, and it's just, like, one of the most incredible. It's just such a, it's like God's work on display. It's like you're looking at something so immense and so much bigger than you and so beautiful that it's just, it's overwhelming. And I love places like that. So Joseph, my mom asked if you are married. I'm not married. But I could be soon. What's up, Joseph's mom? How you doing? Nice to meet you. Send me a message. Maybe we'll grab some coffee as well. Let's see here. Lots of people means, oh, I love you guys. Oh, that's what it means. Écouvant Julie means I love you guys. Oh, well, that's fantastic. Okay, good. Then I said something that I actually mean in a language I don't understand. All right, Julia. How can you produce real tears on set? Well, they are real tears. That's how I produce them. I can't do the fake cry thing. Like, I can't. I just can't do it. Like, I can try, but I can't do it. So I have to be, like, basically, for me, I'm not acting. I'm just in it. If I'm in it, then I'm in it. If I'm not, then I'm not. And so I'm not going to do the fake. I can't just produce tears. Like, I don't know how people do that. And some people do it believably. And that would make my life a whole lot easier. But I can't do that. So I have to get my place to, or myself to, a very, very dismal and place of suffering to get there. But I guess the good part of that is it's not fake, it's real, and hopefully that's compelling for people. Let's see here. Daisy, can you wish my mom a happy 55th birthday? Daisy, I don't know what your mom's name is because you didn't tell me, but I will say happy birthday. Happy birthday, Daisy's mom. Daisy's mom got it going on. Gilbert, am I a party guy? No, I'm not a party guy. I am the epitome. I'll use my horoscope for this one. So I'm a Capricorn, and we usually don't get we're not the party people. We sit back and like to enjoy the party. I like being in a party atmosphere. It's cool. I like being around a lot of people, but I'm not like a party person. I don't you know, go out and do that sort of thing. Going to like a nice dinner with my friends is like my favorite thing. Or hanging out at one of my friends' places and just just having a good time. So, or going out in the woods and going camping with some people. That's more my speed. Renee, what are you most proud of? Most proud of? I guess I am proud of a lot of things. I mean, I'm proud of that I'm able to be an actor for a living, which is my dream. I'm proud that I picked up my entire life and moved out here on a whim. I'm proud of a lot of things. I'm proud that I'm an Eagle Scout. I'm proud of a lot of things that I've accomplished in my life, and you should be too. You know, life is suffering, and it's a very hard place, and it's a lot to deal with on a daily basis. So, like, the fact that we get out of bed and do things at all is pretty compelling. So, which sounds like a bad way to look at the world, but really it's not, because you're always grateful and feeling gratitude. Mariola, what's your biggest blooper? I have a lot of bloopers. What's my biggest blooper? Well, I'll say from the show, from Bold and the Beautiful, I had a fight scene on the roof with Scott, where I beat the crap out of him like 3 times in a row. I don't know why I didn't get the picture. Anyway, so we get into this fight, but it was funny. We had to choreograph this fight in like literally 10 minutes. It was like during lunch, go eat your food, then meet us here, and then we're going to choreograph a fight, which is like a 20 to 30 point fight. Like there's a lot of different movements that need to happen to make this whole thing come about. And there was like at least 10 or 15 hiccups when we were shooting that because we were trying to remember exactly what was supposed to go next. So like the one that always bothers me, and I have video of this, so that's great, is that I like tried to throw Scott, but I didn't throw him with enough force. And so he threw himself, but he threw himself in the opposite direction that I was throwing him. And it looked terrible. And it was like obvious that I wasn't doing anything. And I was like, well, that doesn't look good. Okay. Let's see here. Anita, where do I live? Where do I live? I live in Los Angeles, California. 92536 Sunset Boulevard. It's not an address. I don't know where that is. I live somewhere in LA, in the greater Los Angeles area. But I'm looking at other places. So maybe the Netherlands? I don't know. Seems beautiful there. Let's see. What else? Can you say my mom's name? Rosina. Eric. Rosina. I hope I said her name. Did I say her name? Rosina. I think that Rosina is how you say that. I don't know if there's another way you can. Shadira, can you tell me where the clothes of Kiara come from? Kiara's clothes. you mean our beautiful Kiara? Zoe? Is that her? Where her clothes come from? I don't know. I don't know where anybody's clothes come from. Except for some of mine. I know some of mine. I mean, we have like some Burberry and Gucci stuff. We've had some of that recently. Some of the stuff comes from like Zara. But that's just for me, they don't care about me. They don't care about, making me look really, really fancy. But, I have no idea. I have no idea. It's more of a question for her or our costume designer. Okay. Debbie, do you have friends on set? Yeah, I do. I'm friends with everyone. Hope I didn't speak out of turn there. There's probably someone who hates me, but, honestly, when I came onto the show, it was sort of, it was this overwhelmingly weird experience because usually there's at least a few bad apples and there weren't. I mean, like there's just so many great people, that work on this show. So I'm just glad to be on it. Sarah, how much longer will you be online? I'm getting off here in about 5 minutes. Okay. So this is our final call for questions, not for alcohol. Anyway. So yeah, about five more minutes. So let's keep them pouring in, guys. All right. Let's see here. Sylvia, when is my birthday? December 27th. And I was born in 1987. Don't tell anybody. I'm that old. All right. Or I'm that young, depending on who you are. I mean, it'd make you feel bad if that was the thing. I just feel old because every day I wake up and it's like I have to make noises when I get out of bed, and that's not good. Let's see here. Marika, you are much more more funny than Thomas. Well, good. I hope I made you laugh. And yeah, Thomas isn't exactly a funny guy. I think he's got some good moments though. I like to throw in a little. It's never written in the script, but anytime you have Thomas throwing out like a little quirk, that's usually me trying to bring a little bit of a light to the situation because Thomas finds himself in a lot of. Stuffy situations, shall I say? Okay. Anouk, can you say my name? Well, you're screen recording right now, Anouk. Anouk. I think it's Anouk. What's up, Anouk? I think that's... If I didn't say that right, I'm sorry. I've never heard that. A lot of these names I've never heard before. So I'm just going on a whim and trying to say them. And I probably butchered all of them. But... if I didn't, then I'm very proud. That's another thing I'm proud of. To go back to the other question. Heyo, callback. All right. Cassandra, how did you become an actor? For the girls. in high school, Actually, before high school, you go. So between our grades of, we have middle school is 6th, 7th, and 8th grade, and then 9th through 12th is high school. And in 8th grade, you go over to the high school to meet with the electives teachers and figure out what electives you want to take and what classes you want to do and what you're interested in. And so I went over there, and I was with my dad, and I'm walking down the hall, and the theater teacher stops us, and she goes, have you ever thought about doing theater? And I said, no, honestly, I haven't. I mean, like, I did a play when I was, like, in 5th grade or 4th grade, but not because I really wanted to or act or anything. It was just, like, a thing to do. And she was like, well, she gave me a whole pitch about it, and she was this lovely person, and she said, well, toward the end, I was sort of like, I'm on the fence about this whole theater thing, you know. But she was like, well, you should really think about it, because we have a lot of girls who love to do theater, but not very many guys want to do it. And I was like, I like those odds. So I started acting. And then I actually fell in love with it, because the first time I did a play, it was a comedy, and making the whole theater laugh was like, it was like a drug to me. So I got just more and more involved in doing that, and then into drama, and then, you know, playing all different kinds of characters, and that's how I kind of progressed. Okay, let's see here. Thank you for taking time to call, talk to us. It's very nice in Corona time. Really? Well, I mean, really? It's not that nice. Look, I love reaching out to the fans, and you guys are the reason that I'm working. Also, my buddy is walking in right now, so he's going to ruin your entire take. You should say hi to the fans, by the way, Morgan. But anyway, let's see here. I think it's a pleasure that we even have the ability to talk to people online and be able to connect with the fans. I mean, this is like an incredible experience in itself. So thank you for logging on and just, you know, being a part of it. It's so cool, especially in this time. I mean, right now, people aren't communicating and in touch with each other like they should be. And so, you know, the fact that we have, I guess, this technology and we're able to do this is such a blessing. Let's see here. Cindy, will you ever be able to meet and greet? Will there ever be a meet and greet with you when you're in the Netherlands? Maybe. I don't know. We have to figure that out. It's possible, I guess. But, you know, it all depends on travel restrictions, all that stuff. And then, you know, but I would love to come to the Netherlands and do a meet and greet. Sharon, what's your dream car? That's ever changing, Sharon. It is ever changing. I don't know. Right now I'm into the new Rivian, which is like an electric pickup that's coming out. And it's like an adventure vehicle. And because I love camping and all that kind of stuff. And, electric cars are just cool. I'm such a car guy, and I got an electric car, and it's just so freaking fast. And it's just awesome. It's like instant acceleration. But it's also quiet when you want it to be. It's just great. And so, I thought about getting the new Rivian. I've asked them to send me a Rivian. They're not going to do that. I asked them though. I sent them a message on Instagram and hopefully they'll see this and give me a Rivian, but, that's never going to happen. Let's see here. Can you say my name? Very hard, I think. Yes, I would say so, cause I'm looking at it and I don't even know where to start. So, Tipki. I don't know what it is. You're right. It is very hard. I can't even. I don't know where to start. That's actually the most unique name I think that I've ever tried to say. I wouldn't even know. Tipki, Chipki, Tick. Ship. I don't know. You need to send me a video message of you saying that name so that I know what it is. Hi, Morgan. Someone said hi. Hi. Yeah, no, I was saying someone from the Netherlands said hi.
Oh.
Anyway.
Hello.
Morgan says hi. A Ford Raptor would fit me, Julia. Yes, I love the Ford Raptor. The problem with the Raptor that I see so far. It's an awesome truck and I really want one. And I have actually for a while. But the problem that I have with it is, like, right now my vehicle that I use for off-roading is a 4Runner. And it's like, it's kind of small and narrow. I can get through trails. Like, a lot of these trails when you're going off out into the wilderness get really, really narrow. And the Ford Raptor is like, I don't know, 8 or 9 inches wider than my truck currently. And so it would be really hard to fit that thing on a trail. And I might be scared to do that. But out in the desert, oh, that's such a cool truck. Anyway, okay, so I'm gonna answer two more questions. And then I'm getting offline. So two more. Can you say my name? Katharina. That's not a question, but I'll just say it. So there's a gimme. Who is Morgan? He is a friend of mine. He's a guy. He's a guy with a name and a face. we've been friends for years, and he's helping me with some of this this renovating stuff because I almost blew up my house doing electrical work, and so I asked for some help. I'm not beneath that. Let's see here. Is Evil Thomas coming back? Maybe. I don't know if he's going to come back soon. I have a feeling that Evil Thomas is in there somewhere, though, so I think if someone wronged Thomas, then Evil Thomas might come out, but for the good reasons, maybe. I think that would be cool to have, you know, because everyone knows how crazy Thomas can be, but then, you know, you have him kind of being good, but then if someone actually really wrongs him or his family, then it's like, you know, you don't want to mess with that guy. Okay, I've got one more question. Favorite music. So two more questions. I can't stop. Two more questions. Why is Ridge going back and forward to Brooke? I just want to answer the question. I don't know. Why? I mean, look, Catherine Kelly Link. I love Catherine. I love her to death. But I don't understand. I don't understand why. Why would that? That doesn't make sense. And also, like, she has been hating on Thomas. I mean, somehow she has this ability to just know what's going on with everyone, even though she doesn't talk to them or see them. She knows that Thomas is crazy when he's crazy. And then she also still thinks Thomas is crazy, even after all the good things he's done. It's like, you can't win with Brooke. And then also, it's not like she's a saint over there. I mean, what is she doing? You know, she has been a good wife at times, but, like, she's been married to his dad. That's already weird. And then Bill always comes into the picture and she can't seem to, you know, close her eyes on that one. So I don't get it. I don't know. But I love Catherine Kelly Lang. So, you know, best I can do. Anyway, and then how many more years will Bold be airing on TV? Do I sing? I'm going to answer all the questions. It's like I can't stop. Okay, so how many more years will Bold be airing on TV? I don't know. We're picked up for a couple more, so we'll be on air for at least a couple more years, but I don't know. And then, you know, it's a never-changing atmosphere, so we might move on to I don't know. It's just like there's all these streaming services and things like that. So it's possible that we might. I don't know. It's like what would be the next step if say cable television was nixed completely? Then there's obviously the CBS app and that sort of thing. Maybe we produce it there. I don't know. 20 years from now, you still want to see Thomas going around driving crazy cars and trying to kill people? I don't know. Let's see. Can I have your number? Sorry, Sophia, I can't just like say that out there because then everyone's gonna have my number, and I don't know, that might be weird or that might be fun. Maybe I'll think about that. I'll think about giving you my number. How late is it at my place? It's actually early. Early is all relative, but it's 11 a.m. right now, 11:10 a.m. So yeah, it's a lot later where you guys are. And then, thanks for this. Well, thanks. Thank you, Sarah, and all of you for coming on. And yeah, everybody stay safe. It's a crazy world out there, but you got to live in it. And it's a beautiful world. So go out in it. So I'm going to end this thing and stop answering questions. I'm done answering questions. I really want to answer another question. How much do I cost an hour? Really? That's your question? Come on. $3. Thanks for the live chat. Thank you, everyone. It's been amazing doing this whole thing. It's so nice. It's so nice to be able to connect with the fans like this. This is such a great experience. And now I'm 11 minutes over what I said I was going to do. So I'm going to log off now. But I love you guys. Thank you so much for watching the show. And I am excited to get the show out to you guys, and hopefully I can do what we were talking about earlier. Maybe I can come to the Netherlands and meet some of you. That would be amazing. Anyway, hope you guys have a wonderful day. Get outside, do something, be active, and love the people in your life, because you know that's what's important. Anyway, I'll see you guys later, and bye.